subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates. Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we'll try to understand Boise chord normal form, which is also called as BCNF, and it is also called as stricter third normal form, strict third normal form, or it is also called as 3.5 NF. So the Boise chord normal form is called as strict third normal form because when compared with the third normal form, the Boise chord normal form is a bit stricter. So why it is stricter and how it is stricter, that we will try to understand with this example. And before that, we will try to understand the definition of the Boise chord normal form. A relation schema R is in Boise chord normal form if whenever a non-trivial functional dependencies, whenever a non-trivial functional dependencies which are related to the given relationship, which are related to the given relation, X determines A holds in R. Whenever a non-trivial functional dependencies X determines A holds in R, then X is a super key of R. So that is whenever any functional dependency X determines A holds in R, then X is a super key of R. So what is third normal form states? So the third normal form states that whenever a functional dependency, non-trivial functional dependencies X determines A holds in R, then X is a super key of R, or A is a prime attribute of R. So if any of these property holds on this non-trivial functional dependency X determines R, if any of this property, which means if X is a super key of R or A is a prime attribute of R, if any one of these property holds on if a non-trivial functional dependency X determines A, then that functional dependency is there in the third normal form. So the discussion about third normal form and the examples on third normal form has been done in our previous videos. If you haven't watched that video, please watch those videos and come back here. Without the understanding of third normal form, it may not be possible for you to understand Boise chord normal form. And as when we come to the definition of a Boise chord normal form, it states that whenever a non-trivial functional dependency X determines A holds in a relation R, then X is a super key of R. So it is stricter because it is not allowing this, it is not allowing this this property to be true. So it is accepting only one property, that is X is a super key of R. So that is the reason why it is called a strict third normal form. So this may not bring you clarity on the concepts that we have discussed. We will try to understand this definition and also in comparison with the third normal form by using that example. So what this example states is, here we are having three columns. It is for example, if you take the relation R, it is a relation R, and the three columns are student, course and instructor. Student, a specific student taking a course, and the instructor, so the instructor of that course. Okay, so now the functional dependencies that holds on this relation R, it is a student comma course determines instructor. So the combination of student and course is determining instructor, and instructor determines course. So the instructor is determining course. So with this property of third normal form, we will still have redundancy. So that we will try to understand by this example. For example, if you take this and we will decompose it down to third normal form, we will convert this into third normal form and we will check. Okay, so now coming to the how to find Coming to this example, how to find the primary key for this, candidate keys for this functional dependencies? It is what are the attributes that are not there on the right hand side of the functional dependencies? It is student. So if you take a student and find the closure of this, it has to determine all the properties, all the attributes of the relation. So is it determining? Student determines student, it is trivial functional dependency. Are there any functional dependencies which are determined? Are there any attributes which are determined by student alone? So there are no functional dependencies. So student is capable of determining only student. So what we have to do, if it is not a candidate key, then we have to go for all the combinations that are possible with student. So what are the other combinations which are possible with student? It is student comma instruction. So we will take two attribute combination. It is student comma instructor. What is the closure of student comma instructor? The closure of instructor student. So we will take student as S, instructor as I, and course as C. Student comma instructor determines student comma instructor, and instructor is determining C. So all the attributes of the relation are determined by using the combination of student comma instructor. So this is a candidate key. Let's check the other combinations which are possible. Student comma course. We must have this student, because without student we may not be able, we were not able to determine the student on the left hand, on the right hand side. So that is the reason why we have taken only the combinations which are involved with students. So now student comma course, it determines S comma C. S stands for student and C stands for course, and student comma course is determining instructor. So there are two candidate keys for this relation. It is student comma instructor and student comma course. Why we are not taking the three attribute combination? So why we are not taking instructor comma course combination? Because instructor comma, you take the closure of instructor comma course, it is not going to determine the all the attributes of a relation, because the student attribute is not there on the right hand side. Okay, so the discussion about determining the candidate keys, we have solved lots of examples in our previous videos. So please watch those videos. So these are the two attributes. Adding anything to it is going to be a super key, because if you add course to it, it is going to be a super key. Okay, so if you take three attribute combination, we have only one combination, it is student, instructor and course. And so these are the two candidate keys that are possible for this relation. Okay, so now we have to check whether these functional dependencies with respect to the third normal form, with respect to the third normal form, we got student comma instructor as one candidate key and student comma course as one candidate key, and every attribute of the relation is a prime attribute. It is not primary key. Prime attribute means the attribute which is involved in the candidate key combinations. So the attributes which are involved in the candidate key combinations is called as prime attribute, and we have every attribute of the relation as a prime attribute. So according to the third normal form, we have to check for every functional dependency whether any of these properties is getting satisfied or not. So the first property is X determines A. Is X is a super key of R? Student comma course, yes, it is a super key of R. What is this? This is what we call it as a candidate key, right? So this is a super key of R. Okay, so this is getting satisfied, so it is accepted in third normal form. Similarly, if you take a second functional dependency, is instructor determines course, is that functional dependency is in third normal form? Now coming to the property, first property, X is a super key of R. So if you take this as X and this as A, is X a super key? No, it is not a super key, because the super key should at least have any of these combinations. Student instructor or student course. Okay, so it is not a super key, and we have to check for the other property. What is the other property? A is a prime attribute of R. Is A prime attribute of R? Yes, A is a prime attribute of R. What are the attributes, prime attributes that are involved? What are the attributes that are involved in the candidate keys? It is a student, instructor, and course. So course is a prime attribute. The attribute which is involved in the candidate key combinations is what we call it as prime attribute. So course is a prime attribute. So this one is accepted. So this one is accepted because the second property is getting satisfied. So both these functional dependencies are in third normal form. There is no need to decompose the decompose these functional dependencies into a separate table. But what is the problem with the third normal form? The problem with the third normal form is, even though it is in third normal form, still the redundancies will exist. How that happens? We have taken this as a functional dependencies which is accepted in third normal form, and that functional dependency is accepted by this property. What that property is? A is a prime attribute of R. So with this we are going to have redundancy. How that happens? So they are stating that instructor is determining course. Instructor is determining course means you take an instructor name, he is going to determine the course. So Mark is determining database. Navate is determining database. Wherever you take Navate, so it is determining database. Okay. Wherever you take Mark in the instructor, it is determining database. Similarly, if you take Amar, Amar is determining operating system. You take Amar at any point of this column, it is going to determine operating system. It is the course. So the operating system course is determined by instructor. So there is a redundancy. So with less number of values, you may not find the redundancy. For example, if you take Navate repeating for 1,000 times in this column, how many times the database will get the database value will get repeated every time? 1,000 times it is going to get repeated as database. So there is a redundancy even in the third normal form. That can be avoided. That is the reason why Boisy-Codd normal form is called a stricter version of third normal form. It is stricter version of third normal form because it is not accepting this property. Okay, so the only property that is accepted by Boisy-Codd normal form is X is a super key of R. So it is the only property that is accepted. So with that now, is this functional dependency in Boisy-Codd normal form? We will try to check these functional dependencies for BCNF. Whether this is in Boisy-Codd normal form? Yes, it is in Boisy-Codd normal form because student comma course is a super key of R. X is a super key of R. Based upon that, this is accepted. But is it accepted according to the Boisy-Codd normal form? Because we are not going to consider this property. So instructor determines course. Is X is a super key of R? No, it is not a super key. So this has to be decomposed. Are you able to understand? So now, according to the Boisy-Codd normal form, this has to be decomposed. Okay, how the decomposition has to be done? In what way we are going to decompose these tables? So let's decompose these tables in a specific way. It is a instructor comma course. So the first decomposition is instructor comma course, and the other decomposition is instructor comma student. So this decomposition is done in such a way. It is instructor comma course is one decomposition and instructor comma student is another decomposition. So we have three attribute relation. That three attribute relation is getting divided into these two decompositions. Okay, so this is the decomposition that is done on the functional dependencies of a relation based upon Boyce-Codd normal form. So there is a problem with Boyce-Codd normal form also. So what that problem is, whether this decomposition is a lossless decomposition, whether this decomposition is preserving functional dependencies. So we said that every decomposition should be a lossless decomposition and it should preserve all the functional dependencies. So that is very important to verify for every decomposition. So we have verified for every decomposition in first normal form, second normal form and third normal form. So what is lossless decomposition? The discussion about lossless decomposition is already made in our previous videos. So whenever the decomposition is joined, so it is done on whenever the decomposition is joined, it is done on a common attribute. So here the common attribute is instructor. So whenever we join the decomposition, it is done, natural join is done on the common attribute, and that common attribute should be a primary key. That common attribute should be a primary key should be a common attribute for the decomposition, and that decomposition should be a prime attribute of one of the relation. So it is satisfying. So I is a prime attribute in one of the relation. So it is lossless decomposition. Whether the functional dependencies are preserved or not, let's check. So if you take this, what are the instructor determines course. So for this relation, this functional dependency is related. So this functional dependency is related to this relation, and is this functional dependency preserved? No, that functional dependency is not preserved. So what happens with the BCNF is, BCNF may not preserve the functional dependencies. That is the problem with BCNF. Up to third normal form, all the functional dependencies are preserved and all the decompositions are lossless decomposition. But in the case of third normal form, functional dependencies may not be preserved. So if you decompose the tables based upon the properties of Boyce-Codd normal form, the functional dependencies of the relation may not be preserved. Even though functional dependencies are preserved or not preserved, we are going to decompose according to the Boyce-Codd normal form, because in order to avoid the anomalies that are possible like insertion anomalies, update anomalies and delete anomalies, which we have discussed in the introductory classes of normalization. So in order to avoid those anomalies, we are going to decompose the table into Boyce-Codd normal form. In the Boyce-Codd normal form, the functional dependency, this is very important point to understand, the functional dependencies may not be preserved. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. This is all about Boyce-Codd normal form. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding this concept, please post your doubt in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.